Dammi, last night here, there were 600 people. The DJ Alon spotted you up there and he started to play your remix. What happened then?
Oh my gosh, so last night I was meant to perform here and I had a sneak preview, you know, I wanted to see what the room was like, so I just sneak upstairs to have a look at what, you know, everyone was doing, and then the DJ started playing my song, Sound of Silence, and then everybody just spotted me, and I just felt like I needed to do something cool, but I'm not a cool person, so I was just like, some people took that on video and it's now available forever on the internet.
Can you tell us how it felt, like the technical side of the production that we're doing is quite tricky. Tell us what some of that's like and what some of the pitfalls are we've got to be careful of.
When I signed up to do Eurovision, I knew I had to sing, so I've been practicing the song, but I didn't realise that I had to do all these extra things like sitting up on a really high box that really felt like the surface of the box feels like sandpaper. So, you know, I had to sit on it, you know, before I started. It's really painful, but then I can bear with the pain, but the dress is, you know, it's made by Steve and Khalil. It's a great, you know, expensive dress. And when I was coming off the podium, the dress started to kind of tear apart because it didn't want to let go. And so that's been a challenge that Paul's been dealing with. And, you know, also coming off the podium, you know, obviously I couldn't jump off because it's much taller than I am. So we had to get two technicians, big, you know, Swedish muscly men to just put me down. But they got confused about the timing. So one guy came really early and I was like, I was singing, going, not yet, not yet. And then, oh, and then the other man was like, oh my gosh. And he joined and then they dragged me off and I went, ah! And that got released to everybody. That's what Eurovision is. So, yeah, we have to work on that.
How have you found the energy of the fans and the audience here in Stockholm? What's been your fun?
The energy has been really incredible and, you know, I was warned that it was going to be really crazy and there'll be fans everywhere, you know, getting snaps and asking for autographs. But the other day we were just going out for dinner and then we were on the pedestrian crossing and a guy asked me for an autograph and I was like, sorry, I want to survive to actually perform at the show. So things like that, it's been really, really crazy. Seeing all the fans and the Dammi Army get behind me, so I'm really just overwhelmed by all the amazing support and the reaction.
Thank you, everyone. Would you like to hear Dammi perform now?